So let's begin by taking a nice deep breath of Archangel Gabrielle gold, that beautiful deep Florentine gold, the old yellow. Breathe in, open your crown, open your heart, open your solar plexus and your root and everything in between. And breathe in that beautiful old molten gold. Feel that gold as a river of lava, rich, thick, liquid, coming down into your crown, covering your hair, your face, your torso, your legs, covering Gaia from the North Pole to the South Pole. Breathe in the gold, the fall chrysanthemums, your mother's wedding ring. An old treasured locket. The Colorado aspens in the late fall. And feel that gold and the warmth of Gabrielle's love come down through your crown, activating your pineal, your pituitary, your hypothalamus. Let it open your throat chakra so that we, like her, become those trumpets of truth, those messengers of one. Come into your heart and feel that warmth filling you, nurturing you, expanding you, and feel it moving down like lava into your solar plexus, into your seat of will, your hara, your decision place for action. Fill your tummy and fill your central column, that beautiful column around your spinal cord, from the tip of your tailbone, from your root, all the way up to your crown, until each of us is some Marvel comic creature, gold beings, gold light bodies. And relax and give yourself the gift of your love, your presence, your focus, your choices to be the joy, to be the truth. To be the trumpet of truth. now open wider. Gabrielle wants us all to put on golden gloves. And they're really pretty. For those of you who remember, it's like those little white gloves we used to wear to church or to weddings. For the guys, the tight leather of driving gloves, but they're gold, that beautiful gold, so that everything you touch and come into contact with, you ignite with this gold of joy. Greetings, I am Gabrielle, Archangel Gabrielle, Lily of Love, Trumpet of Truth, Messenger of One, Spokesbeing for this mighty Council of Love, of which you, my beloved ones, are part of. Above and below, within and without, you always have been. And so I welcome you this day and every day. And yes, I fill you with great glory and deepest gratitude with my gold, with my joy. But this joy and this gold and this frequency has been gifted to me from the Mother, Father, One. We have all begun, dear hearts, in exactly the same place, in exactly the same realm of existence. And that is in the heart of the Mother, Father, One. There is and there cannot be any deviation. As Mr. Dr. Professor Einstein has told you, all patterning from the seashell to the oceans to the sky to the mountains to the trees to the humans is patterned upon the Mother. You carry the essence of her design. But I come on behalf of the Mother, Father, One this day. Yes, of special assignment, you might say. To speak to you, my beloved ones, about this issue, might I say, this tragedy of indifference and apathy. Now, I am not here, well, not today anyway, I am not here to preach at you, although I would still like to remind you about the increase of energies in the 13th octave and beg you to please do this meditation, because that will have profound influence upon the apathy and indifference of the collective. But let me begin at the beginning. Why I have begun by speaking about how all is patterned upon the Mother. Would it not make you wonder, child, how it would ever happen that any being in any reality, and certainly any human being, how they could possibly reach a place of indifference? We are not talking devastation. We are not talking recalcitrant. We are not talking chaos. Although, in fact, it does create greater chaos. It is the current beneath the waves. And do not forget that the mother's tsunami also continues above the waves, below the waves, within the waves, and within every particle of water, whether it is in the Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, or the ocean of water within thee. It has not halted and will not halt until such time as all is done. So I feel that I am your memory jogger because I am also reminding you of the gifts of the tsunami of love, and that is clarity, purity, and grace. Now, what does this look like in action? Well, it certainly doesn't look like you're sitting at home eating bonbons. And you aren't. And I would never make that assumption, although I have spotted a few of you enjoying yourselves, and that is a good thing. But let me stick to the subject, for I do have a tendency at times to rant and rave and ramble, do I not? I know you will give me leeway in this. When all is patterned along, duplicated from the essence of the mother, that means that the divine patterning, the unique soul design, which is different, singularly unique to each and every one of you, but it is divinity, and it does not carry the essence of indifference, of apathy. Indifference is the ability, the choice, the decision, conscious, unconscious, subconscious, it matters not, to disengage from your own life and from the life of the collective, from your own mission and purpose, and the mission and purpose of the collective. It is a profound denial, which is very sad, of the truth of who you are. Now you know I am not addressing you who are dedicated, anchored light workers and love holders. For you have dedicated your life to this path. But there are times, if you examine truthfully and without fear of being observed, when you will see this indifference even within your own heart, and it has become, shall I say, a self-protective mechanism. Because you look at a situation and you say, well, there really isn't anything I can do to change that, to affect that, to influence that. So I will simply back away. And although if I really engaged with it, it would hurt my heart. So what I will do is simply back away and put my attention elsewhere. Now, there are times when you do this that it is a brilliant strategy. And then there are times when you do this when you are simply in denial. So I want you to understand what this indifference feels like in terms of up close and personal, because it is up close and personal. Now think of it in this way. When you have billions of human beings who, for a variety of reasons, and I would suggest they are legitimate in the human rationale, who have disengaged because they feel they do not have the adequate power or the wherewithal to address situations, energies, structures, people that they do not understand. Now, this takes two forms. It can be reactive behavior, but most often it is simply withdrawal. That is not an area that I can influence. And therefore, I will stand back, not as the observer, participant, observer, our observer, participant, but simply to draw so far back that they are removing themselves from truly observing and participating in any way, shape, or form. And I am talking about those that live in a very comfortable situation, what you would think of as a middle-class situation in a wealthy country, to those that have been tortured and maimed in war-torn places. Both and all of this withdrawal, this indifference, this embodiment of indifference is dangerous. Now, what I mean by dangerous is that it is a denial of the very mission and purpose and why that person is upon the planet. Life is meant, intended to be an adventure. A glorious adventure of exploration. Yes, we know that the term journey is often utilized. But I say to you this day and every day, life is intended to be an adventure. For you to go exploring, to observe and then to participate, and vice versa. In everything, the material, the emotional, the blessed, the sublime, the mental, it is all there. If you go diving into the massive nature of the ocean, you see that there is an entire world there to be discovered that is not readily apparent when you are on the waves. And you travel, you move with what attracts your attention and with the currents. And with the mother tsunami. And it is filled with awe and wonder and a joy of knowing that you are part of that exploration, that adventure. So what happens to those that sit on the shore and say, oh, I'm not interested. I don't feel like it. I'm afraid. They are missing out on the best part because obviously there was a part of them that felt urged or were convinced that it was desirable to go to the beach, but they haven't taken the next step. Fear, as you well know, because I have taught you this many, many times, it freezes you in place. It is those false expectations about reality. False expectations. Human expectations. That if you go into the water, you're going to be bit by a shark or swept away by a tidal current or a riptide. And it freezes you onto the sand where you are getting gritty and sunburned. And that isn't exactly enjoyable either, is it? Then there are those who are indifferent, and this is what we are talking about, who say, I am content to sit here and simply observe. It is not sufficient. The reason so many of the collective have reverted, yes, reverted, you are not born that way, you have reverted to the level of indifference, of disconnection, of apathy, is the sense that you have lost your freedom and your birthright to power, to the power of yes and no and doing and action. And during this extraordinary time of change, if there is one thing that is being requested of the human race, it is to step forward in action to create and co-create Nova Being and Nova Earth. So it is not that they are fighting you. If there was a good fight, a drag them out, a vigorous debate, then it would be worthwhile because both sides would present and be heard. Of course, always speaking in Sador. But it is when there is such apathetic response that they simply do not wish to engage either in the conversation, the actions, and the realization of individual mission and purpose tied to collective mission and purpose, that we have a problem, dear heart. Now, when I say we have a problem, I am talking collectively. You have a problem, and we have a problem. From our side, we are doing more than you could ever imagine. And I am filling you all with my strongest gold. You are filled with the Mother Tsunami. You are filled with the upgrades and activations and frequencies. Saint Germain is ever present, as is Jesus Sananda. In fact, there is not one master that is not fully engaged in this undertaking, as well as we who are of the archangelic and various angelic realms. Your star brothers and sisters are working flat out with you. But what reaches this level of indifference, this level of apathy, is engagement. And that is vitally important. And I would suggest to you, very strongly, that it is your role, your job, to engage these beings. And you say to me, well, Gabrielle, Gabby, how on earth am I supposed to do this? Too often, you hold your tongue, something I've never been accused of. When you realize that the person that you are chatting with doesn't really like or feel comfortable with the direction the conversation is taking. And you are far too polite, my beloveds, to say, what is it about this conversation that bothers you? What is it that makes it uncomfortable? Is there a way that we can engage in this conversation in ways that will allow us to truly exchange feelings, ideas, understandings, wisdom, knowledge? You may be challenged. And that is all right. Because the conversation is the awakening, your outpouring of love, of compassion, and the willingness to engage, to risk, wakens others. Now they may say, I am strictly a Christian and I will only go by what my church tells me. And that is all right, because you have made them commit and open up to what they really believe. There are a million roads back to the mother. There are a million roads back home. And as long as they are of love, of purity, of clarity and grace, it does not matter. All are equally valid as long as they are of truth. And not merely of denial or self-protection. So the conversation has need to take place. And yes, I am asking you, I am challenging you, I am inviting you, and I am begging you. Energetically, yes, send the love. In your peace meditations on Sunday night, send the love. But follow up. The conversation with this majority has need to be engaged in. It is not that this majority in any way is recalcitrant or reluctant, perhaps nervous, a little reluctant. But they have been injured along the way. They have felt that they have lost their power. They have been stuck in the quagmire of the altar that doesn't even exist. So you are reaching out your hand and your heart and you're saying, come here. Let's talk about this. Heart to heart, human to human, angel to angel. You are inquiring them. What is in their hearts? What happened that they disengaged to this extent? Many will say, I am too busy. I have a full-time job. I am a mother. I have a relationship. I have community work. All worthy. But it does not displace. It cannot displace why one is upon planet. You do not wish to have, you cannot anyway, but you do not wish to have a creation of Nova Earth with many people who are simply indifferent. Most human beings believe in the Godhead, in whatever variation there is. They believe in the angelic kingdom. They believe in Gaia. They believe in the goodness ultimately of humanity. But they have not witnessed it, not in the fullness of what is possible. You are the bringers, the birthers, the carriers of potential. And you are translating that potential into actuality. That is what this phase is about. It is not about leaving planet. It is about staying put. Are we willing, ready, able to assist thee beyond measure? Absolutely. We give you everything you need. You do not undertake this alone. We will gladly cohabitate with thee as the words flow. But dear hearts, we are counting on you in the human realm as our sacred partners to eradicate indifference. Let us begin right now. Go with my love, and go, sweet angels, in peace.